A major boost to Make in India. In the defence sector, the Indian Army will get the first 12 indigenously developed 10-metre short-span bridging systems, which will help the forces come over geographical obstacles like small rivers and canals in case of operations along the western borders with Pakistan. Now, the equipment is worth over rupees 492 crore and will be handed over to the Corps of Engineers by the Army Chief General Manoj Mukund Naravane. Joining me on the broadcast is my colleague Shivani to give us more details. What more can you tell us with regards to this entire, project and...
Crispino, this is a major boost to the Make in India campaign of the Indian Defence Forces, which are transforming exponentially. And here where I'm present, General M.M. Naravane, he's inspecting the system which is being inducted into the Indian Defence Forces. This is the first of its kind, indigenously built 10-meter short span bridging system that has been designed by the DRDO. It has been manufactured by Larsen & Toubro in India. And this will be enhancing the capabilities of our bridging systems, which are present with us. And in the first lot, these 12 bridging systems are being inducted into the Corps of Engineers of Indian Army. If I can show you these bridging systems, which have been kept here for the demo and will be inducted into the Corps of Engineers. We already had 5-meter short span bridging system, but the 10-meter short span bridge is for the first time becoming a part of the Indian Army, and this will be quite helpful, especially on the western borders of the country, where there are a number of nalas, rivers, and water bodies that need to be crossed over by the vehicle, especially the 70-ton heaviest tank of Indian Army. So this is enhancing the capability of Indian Defence Forces with the power of Make in India. And 100 of these systems will be a part of the Indian Army by the year end of 2023. So 12 are being introduced and inducted today. Another lot will be in a few months and so on. So despite the COVID second surge and whatever the country is facing, this delivery is on schedule, and the focus of the Indian Defence Forces has been in past few years, Crispino, to develop indigenously, not to depend on any other country. So this is the system which will definitely enhance the bridging capabilities of the Indian Defence Forces, and it will also strengthen the power over the geographical obstacles in the western border.
Absolutely, and the world is watching India as it makes strides in the defence sector. As you rightly pointed out, the Make in India in the defence sector is certainly a big boost to the Army, with the 12 systems now having been inducted and more to come by the end of this year as well as the next. What are we looking at? How our neighbors are looking at us at this point of time, because India is certainly putting a mark in the world with regards to their defense sector as well.
Certainly, Crispino, India is making a mark in the world. It is showing the world that how one country, in spite of all the adversities, can turn the problem into opportunity, and that's what we are seeing here. When we see these defense systems indigenously being developed each day, we see DRDO having an achievement, maybe be it the successful test fire of the Agni Prime missile or these 10-meter short span bridging systems. So India is growing exponentially, and the focus of the Indian Defense Forces is to become a technology-driven force and not a manpower-driven force. And that's the focus, and that's how the indigenously developed technologies are the major achievement of the Indian Defence Forces. And here also the system which we see here, Crispino, the demo was also shown here when the Army Chief was inspecting and was present in the ceremony. So these systems will be quite capable in overcoming the challenges on the western borders, because the borders in with Pakistan are such that there are a number of water bodies, be it the small nalas, rivers, or even a big canal. So these systems will enhance the power. And very important thing here to mention is that this requires very less manpower. Within a fraction of 7 to 10 minutes, this bridge can be laid with only 4 people. and as heavy as Arjun tank can also cross over this bridge, the short span right. bridging system that has been developed indigenously, designed by the DRDO, manufactured by L&T, and very soon the Corps of Engineers will be having 100 such bridging systems that will empower the army along the western border, and if required ever, they can also be moved to the towards the LAC where these tanks and other vehicles will be deployed.
Do you think it's a game changer in India's warfare capabilities?
Forces that's coming up with the indigenous technology is proving to be a game changer. And these bridging systems will also be a game changer because they are cutting short the manpower, they are cutting short the effort, they are speeding up the bridging capabilities of the Indian Defence Forces. So certainly they are a game changer. And we know that India is an unprecedented position right now along the northern, western and also eastern sector. So this kind of technology enhancement is empowering India, and each development is a game changer for the country, as we see here that with so much of less effort and within a span of 7 minutes, a big canal as big as 75 meters can be crossed over by heavy vehicles of the army.
Right. So this will certainly...